have something they need to acknowledge today? A birthday, an anniversary?
Behind you. Look, lots behind you.
Yes.
My grandson Jack turns 9 tomorrow.
Okay, that's good. Your name is Sammy? 9 tomorrow. Grandson turns 9.
Michelle's not finished.
Michelle.
My daughter turned 40 on Thursday.
Wow. You must have had her pretty young. 40. Anybody else have something to acknowledge? Yes?
Next Thursday, I'm retired a whole year.
Wow, good for you. Renee Sandy. Is there anybody joining us for the first time today? Nobody? Yes, sorry. You are? Well, you stand. I'm going to invite all of the baptism group to stand anyway. Everybody stand here for the blessing, if you don't mind. All of this group here. Okay, anything else? Then we'll sing the blessing.
All good. All good.
Okay. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Mm-hmm. Second week in school, we're still tired. Good morning.
Good morning.
That's it. That's what I like to hear.
So, how many of you were here last week? Put your hand up. And how many of you had some, what is it? And what did you think?
Yes.
Good.
Did you like it?
Yeah.
Big kids, how many of you had some, what is it? Did you like it?
Yes.
Excellent. So, if you remember the story from last week, manna from heaven is called What Is It? And it gave the people of Israel everything they needed when they were in the desert for, do you remember how long? 40 years. Yep. In the desert. And so, what I'm bringing today is a continuation of what I talked about last week. Can anybody read this? What does this say? Right, healthy eating. This is a copy of the Canada Food Guide. And on here it has all the healthy things you should be eating. So I'll let you look at it, then you can just pass it down, and we'll just be passing down, everybody can look at it. It's the Canada Food Guide. So the Canada Food Guide, they keep changing it about every year. This is, I think, version number 10. But just keep passing it down so everybody can have a look at it. And the Canada Food Guide shows you all the healthy things you need to eat to be healthy. When you're in the desert, there's not many healthy things to eat. So, What Is It? Gave the people of Israel what they needed. And in my Bible, which I read before, it says that the people gathered manna, as we call it. They gathered the what is it, and they took as much as they needed. Now, they took as much as they needed because we all need, according to the Canada Food Guide, we need all kinds of things for us to be healthy. Now, I'm an old guy, and I'm pre-diabetic, so I have to watch how many carbs I eat and how much sugar I eat. And because I'm a little overweight, I should watch how much fat I eat. And I should eat more vegetables. Now, all the people of Israel, they were as kids like you. Do you think that you need to eat the same things I need to eat? Or do you think you have to eat a little bit differently? Well, you're still growing, so you need way more calcium than I need. I have calcium, and you'll need more calcium. So, the what is it, or the manna from heaven, not only did they provide them with everything they needed, it provided them individually what they needed. So whatever they ate, God provided them individually what they needed. So children would get more calcium. They didn't need vitamin D because they were in the desert, they had lots of sunshine, but they might have needed vitamin C, and they might have needed other things. They might have needed more fiber in their diet, and that would be included in that. But when I ate the what is it, it wouldn't have a whole bunch of sugar for me, because I don't need a whole bunch of sugar, and I have to watch my carbs, so I don't need a bunch of carbs. So God provided for the people of Israel, while they were in the desert, with the what is it, provided everything they need. And that's a story from Exodus, and I just wanted to show you. So this story is actually almost the very beginning of the Bible, and there's still way more of the Bible to read. But the interesting thing is, and I believe this, God gave the what is it to provide the people of Israel with what they needed. He's still doing that today. He's providing me what I need. He's providing you what you need. Not necessarily in food, but He knows what we need and He provides it. And He provides it to us because He gives us three gifts, which I talked about before. Love, faith, and, does anyone remember the last one? Yes? Hope. So through that, God still provides us what we need. We just have to kind of let Him know. He knows, but we should do we need special requests, or there's things that we know of people who need special requests, we can ask God, and He will do His best to provide for us. So that's sort of the end of my talk now. Do you have any questions about it? No? Okay. Are we going to sing a...
It's on the back of
your... It's
on the back of your...
It's on the back of the program, and it's This Little Light of Mine. Do you want to stand up?
Yes.
And we're going to sing.
In 307, when long before time. Thank you. eternal God, you have ordained and constituted one Lord, in the ministry of angels and mortals.
Our reading from the book of Genesis. Jacob left Beersheba and went toward Haran. He came to a certain place and stayed there for the night, because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones of the place, he put it under his head and lay down in that place. And he dreamed that there was a ladder set up on the earth, the top of it reaching to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And the Lord stood beside him and said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham your father, and the God of Isaac. The land on which you lie I will give to you and to your offspring, and your offspring shall be like the dust of the earth, and you shall spread abroad to the west, and to the east, and to the north, and to the south, and all the families of the earth shall be blessed in you and in your offspring. Know that I am with you and will keep you wherever you go, and will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. Then Jacob woke from his sleep and said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. And he was afraid and said, how awesome is this place! This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will say the psalm found also on the reading. The psalm appointed for the day is Psalm 103. We'll say the opening line at the beginning and ending. The remaining verses we'll say alternately. Bless the Lord, O my soul. The Lord has set his throne in heaven, and his kingship has dominion over all.
Bless the Lord, the angels of his. The mighty ones who do his bidding, and hearken to the voice of his word.
Bless the Lord, all you his hosts, you ministers of his, who do his will.
Bless the Lord, all who work his ways, in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
A reading from the Revelation to John. War broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon. The dragon and his angels fought back, but they were defeated, and there was no longer any place for them in heaven. The great dragon was thrown down, that ancient serpent who is called the devil and Satan, the deceiver of the whole world. He was thrown down to the earth, and his angels were thrown down with him. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven proclaiming, now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Messiah. For the accuser of our comrades has been thrown down, who accuses them day and night before our God. But they were conquered, but they have conquered him by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony, for they did not cling to life even in the face of death. Rejoice then, you heavens, and those who dwell in them. But woe to the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down to you with great wrath, because he knows that his time is short. is the word of the Lord.
For God your hymn is 3, 2, 3. Descending upon the Son of Man. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated.
Those of you who received the email from the church about the services, etc., would have also noticed that this Sunday we will be receiving and or acknowledging the baptismal font, which is right in front of you. Now we try to put the front side forward, and if you'll see it at the base, it says placed at St. Stephen's Church, and then the city and the address. So in other words, when St. Stephen's Church ceased to exist, this font was brought here as we received the community from St. Stephen's here. And I think that's the most important, one of the most important pieces of furniture, if you want to put it, which is in any church. Because it reminds us what happened here. Diane is not here, but if she is listening, she would remember telling me that she herself was baptized in the same pond. And after that, her family. So this font then represents a long history of faith. Faith not only which was proclaimed at St. Stephen's or St. Saviour's, But faith has been proclaimed for 2,000 plus years in different parts of the world by different communities, uniting all of us in that baptism. And at the service says in the opening sentences, one Lord, one faith, one baptism. And that's what it all is. That regardless of our different colors, different denominations, different customs, language, cultures, the one thing which unites every Christian is the baptism, as I'm repeating again, one Lord, one faith, one baptism. So it is, I think, a privilege for the congregation as well as for every one of us to continue on in this tradition and witness the baptism of these three boys today, as we will be baptizing them in the same faith, in the same Lord, and wondering what can be done. Now with the children, Gary was talking about the dietary habits and what he should be or should not be eating. And I think that's true for all of us. That if all of us look at ourselves and say, this is what we should be eating and this is what we should not be eating, if we are true to ourselves, I think maybe 45% of the time I end up eating what I should be eating, the rest of the time I just make excuses and eat it. And that's human nature. That's human nature, that our efforts can go so far and after that there's a full stop. Or our humanity or other expectations, if we can say temptations, take over us or take us over, and then we do eat what we are not supposed to eat. And that's the same thing with our life with God. That we all know what we should be doing. We all know the life we should be living. We all know how to treat our neighbors. We all know what is blasphemy or not. We all know what is sinful or not. But we forget what God's expectations are, and we create our own images, our own dogmas, and our own fears to justify what we can call discrimination of those who are different than us. What we can call the trafficking of women and children who can be trafficked. What we can call racism, which should not be happening. Or what we can call religious superiority, that one faith is better than the other. And we hear that all the time, isn't it? That this faith is better than the other in our own churches. The people at the right will say, if you're not baptized with the Holy Spirit as an adult, then you're not a Christian. Or some will say, if you're not baptized this way, then you're not a good person. So that's where our humanity comes in the way of God. And that's where the Spirit of God, which rests on all of us, stop working and start grieving. And one can say that how could it be that human will can overcome God's will? That's what we know as free will. That Adam and Eve knew they should not be eating that fruit. But they ate. Because their free will, their own will to be like God, made them do that. As we know, the serpent clearly said, if you eat of this tree, you will have the understanding. And they ate. Because they wanted to be like God. And from then till now, as has been mentioned earlier, there have been several demigods who are walking around, creating our own way, our own justification, and coming in the way of God and God's creation. You know, there is a story being told about this very smart man who lived in today's Iran. He was a Sufi, his name was Rumi. And what he did that whenever the students came to join his school, he would put them to test. And his teachers or fellow teachers didn't know what test will he put them. What test will he give to the prospective students? And if they passed the initial test, then they were admitted. So one fine day, this young man shows up and says, "Master, I want to join your community." And he says, "You have 40 days. Go and find something which everyone detests, which everyone avoids, which destroys every good thing. And when you have found it, bring it to me and you will be my student." And the young fellow, as you have been told, laughed and said, "Okay, that's the easy thing. I can find it easily." And the master also said, "But if there's anything, one thing good either said or found in that thing, then it is a good thing." So he went around, he looked at the people who were tipping their elbows too much, he looked at those who were eating too much, swearing, other things, but he kept on finding something good. And on the 40th day, he was walking through the field, dejected, thinking about excuses he could make, and he saw human waste. And he said, "Aha, that's the thing. Because I avoid it, everyone avoids. Come on my clothes, it will soil my clothes," and so on and so forth. And as the story goes, of course, lot of embellishment in a way, but lot of truth, that there's a dialogue which happens between this young man and the waste. And the waste says, "What are you doing?" And young man says, "Taking you to the master, because you are the worst thing in the world. Everyone avoids you, detests you." And the waste said, "Look around and tell me what you see." And the young man said, "Well, I see wheat, I see cows grazing, I see fruit," and kept on saying. And the waste said, "That was me 24 hours ago. I spent 24 hours with you. Look what I was and what I am now." And the student went to the master and said, "That's it. We are the ones who can be either detested by everyone, or we are the ones who are either respected and accepted by everyone." Now we are celebrating the feast of St. Michael and All Angels. If you believe in angels, you should believe that the angels are surrounding us or all around us, and they are the ones who do various things. And St. Michael, as we know, is the one, as Helen wrote, read for us from the Revelations, is the one who fights the evil, is a great warrior, is the one who has overcome the evil. And that's what Revelation continues to remind us, that the evil has been destroyed by God, but it still exists in various forms. So St. Michael gives us hope, gives us promise, that in our efforts to live the life to the best of our abilities, God's Holy Spirit, God's angels, God's Son Himself is directing us, is guiding us, and is helping us to be who we can be, who we should be. And if there's only one thing we want to remember, or we want to follow from God's promise to us at the time of baptism, there will be a question which I'll be asking to the parents, of course, and to all of us, which is, will you seek and serve Christ in every person you meet? And we are going to say, "I will, with God's help." But just listen to it. What is it saying? Will you seek and serve Christ in everyone you meet? And if you keep that as the focus, as the basis of our faith and interaction with the world, then all the things which were counted, from discrimination to trafficking to high school, school backyard bullying to road rage to racism, everything will cease to exist. Because we will not see a person for what they appear to be, we will see a person who he or she really is. A creation of God, an image of God, redeemed by God's Son, and as a Christ, walking, talking, and serving among us. And that person could be the one who cuts us off on a road. And as I know, this is the place where jokingly I tell people that there are places in the world where giving a signal is not an indication, it's a permission. And certain times you have to have a permission of 50 drivers before they let you in. So it could be a person who cuts you off, or a neighbor who will throw all his snow on our yards this coming winter, or somebody whose policies or whose face we do not like, or somebody we are convinced is not a good person. But God says to us and asks us, will you seek and serve that person as Christ? Or will your humanity come between and stand between the work of God and that person? And that's a question which I think can help us to move in several ways. That's a question which can allow us to set an example that even if we are doing that for 50% of our time, we are doing the best we can. And there's no exam, by the way. Because I know, and I guess most of you will agree, that when I'm not eating good, I know it. People will say, well, I feel guilty. Yes. Maybe my sugar meter tells me that I should not be doing that. So in other words, likewise, when we are not following the commandment of God and fulfilling His expectations, we know it. We should know it. We can call it conscience. We can call it God's voice. And at that time, we have to understand that the next moment can be a different moment. The next day can be a better day. The next person can be served and received better than the person who we received or who we did not receive a moment before. Think about it and pray about it. An incredible need in the world at this point, where everything we hear or do from every part or every aspect is designed to divide us, is designed to create fear. But in the midst of that fear, that division, and that us and them, is the word of God which says, one Lord, one faith, one baptism. And it also says, will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hymn number. We continue by singing hymn number 38. Thank you.
godparents of the children to be baptized along with the children to join me here at the font. Take the pictures afterwards. You can, if you can bring the book with you, page 163. Just in front of all. Do you know the presentation of the children? I'm sure please present this to you. Yes, please. Who present these children for baptism?
We present these children for baptism.
And all the questions I'll be asking, you are responding all together. Will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is nurtured in the faith and life of the Christian community?
I will with God's help.
Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ?
I will with God's help.
Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world, which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God?
I renounce them.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept Him as your Savior?
I do.
Do you put your whole trust in His grace and love?
I do.
And now to the people presented here, those who are sitting in the congregation, will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support these persons in their life in Christ?
Amen.
Let us now pray for these candidates who are to receive the sacrament of baptism.
Let us now pray for those persons who are to receive the sacrament of baptism. Deliver them, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open their hearts to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill them with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach them to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send them into the world to witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring them to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of His resurrection and look for Him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We give you thanks, Almighty God and Father, for by the gift of water you nourish and sustain all living things.
Blessed be God forever.
We give you thanks that through the waters of the Red Sea you led your people out of slavery to freedom in the promised land.
Blessed be God forever.
We give you thanks for sending your Son Jesus. For us He was baptized by John in the River Jordan. For us He was anointed as Christ by your Holy Spirit. For us He suffered the baptism of His own death and resurrection, setting us free from the bondage of sin and death, and opening to us the joy and freedom of everlasting life.
Blessed be God forever.
We give you thanks for your Holy Spirit who teaches us and leads us into all truth, filling us with her gifts so that we might proclaim the gospel to all nations and serve you as a royal priesthood.
Blessed be God forever.
We give you thanks for you have called these children to new life through the waters of baptism. Now sanctify this water that your servants who are washed in it may be made clean, made one with Christ in his death and resurrection, to be cleansed and delivered from all sin. Anoint them with your Holy Spirit and bring them to new birth in the family of your church, that they may become inheritors of your glorious kingdom. We give you praise and honor and worship through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Blessed are you, our strength, song, and our salvation.
And on the next page, let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in God the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the Apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
Kenny, I baptize in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I sign you with the cross, and mark you as Christ's own, forever. Amen. Amen. Kenny, I baptize you in the Kyle, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
I sign you with the cross and mark you as Christ's own forever. Amen.
Amen.
Uzair, I baptize in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I sign you with the cross, and mark you as Christ's own, forever. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit, you have bestowed upon these your servants the forgiveness of sin and have raised them to the new life of grace. Sustain them, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give them an inquiring and discerning heart the courage to will and to persevere, a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works.
Amen.
Receive the light of Christ to show your path from darkness into light. Receive the light of Christ to show that your path from darkness into light. Receive the light of Christ to show that your path from darkness into light. And we say, let your light so shine
for others, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven.
Let us welcome the newly baptized.
We receive you into the household of God, confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in his eternal priesthood.
My dear friends, I present to you Kyle, Kenny, and Uzair, the newest members of the body of Christ. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And you can exchange that peace from distance and
thank you.
found on page 198, Eucharistic Prayer number 3, page 198. And you may remain standing, kneel, or sit for the Eucharistic Prayer. The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, gracious God, Creator of heaven and earth. We give you thanks and praise to Jesus Christ our Lord, because in the fellowship of your saints, who have given us a glorious pledge of the hope of our calling, therefore we join our voices with theirs as heaven and earth unite to proclaim the glory of your name.
In the unity of the Holy Spirit,
All honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
As our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
and
Please stand as you are able. And the back cover of the page with the readings, we pray. Eternal God, you have led us to prepare the angels. Maybe you will come with your protection. Let them be continual service and praise to Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God,
whose power between us in the infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the Church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen.
And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you, and remain with you this day and always.
Amen.
Yes, just a few announcements before we dismiss. As always, this service will be uploaded to YouTube later today. Also, the St. Saviour's auction continues, so you'll find that at the St. Saviour's Facebook. I think what the working plan is, talking to Kendra, we're going to continue it, as you see it right now, for about the end of October, and then all of the month of November, what you'll see on the auction will be all Christmas-related stuff. Is that about right, Kendra? Yeah, so look forward to that and decorate your houses for Christmas. It's coming soon all of a sudden, I'm not sure. If anybody's interested in assisting or looking after getting organized for the turkey dinner in November, please see Kendra after that, after this service, I should say. Also, I've been announcing that sooner or later we're going to start the breakfast club next door. That's actually going to happen tomorrow. So if you've been thinking about donating an hour and 15 minutes a week to do that, but you wonder what it's all about, feel free to join Barbara and I tomorrow morning at 7:45 at the school over here, and we'll walk you through all what happens between 7:45 and 9:00, at which time your shift would be over. We still need a couple of volunteers to fulfill our Friday crew. We have a Monday crew, a Wednesday crew, and a Friday crew. So see me after for that. Anything I missed, Kendra?
No.
All good? I think there's coffee. Stick around for coffee. Anything Edmund at all? No? We'll finish with our hymn 662, The Trees of the Field. Ministry continued. So let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.